the Mayweather box up in Vegas. Well, I just caught up with Duane Blake of the Money Team. He just gave us a tour of the gym. Check it out. It's another day here at the office of Duane Blake, the Mayweather box up in Vegas. Who's here at the gym today? Can you give us a quick tour of the gym?
Okay, come on.
All right, let's start.
Where you want to start at?
Where you start right here?
This do it all Bob, jack of all trades. Anything you need done, he does it all. Do it all Bob.
Okay, the big dog house and the little dog house.
The big dog house.
Who's in the dog house right now?
Ronald! Ronald, say what up, Ronald.
Okay.
He's a stone cold killer.
Heavy-handed. And some guys I think fought with his barber.
I don't know. Kitty Blackett.
Andrew
Tabidi.
Okay.
You got Kev, you gotta get Kev. Top amateur prospect, Kev.
What's his nickname?
They call me Flash, they call me Kid Lightning.
Oh, that shit. I never even knew that shit.
They call me all types of shit.
Now you gotta pick one. There are already three Flashes, so I would go with a different one, because Nonito Donaire is the Flash.
No, yeah, that's just random names that they call me.
Well, I didn't even know that shit. Bellos.
Yeah, what's up, Bellos?
Yeah. Compton's finest.
You better know
bang,
it.
Bang.
Why does he always smile, though?
That's what he is. Gotta always keep a smile on your face.
Yeah. It's all business. That's it.
Smile out of the ring? Business in the ring?
Yeah, all day.
Okay. I noticed that they put up new things in the gym. Like, this is pretty new, right?
Yeah, new shit.
Come on.
New gym, this is gym. Hold on. Uncle Gerald.
Ching bang. How you doing, Uncle Gerald?
Me and the little...
The gym babysitter and also holds the gym down. Make sure all the shit is done. Rocco, get Rocco. Get Rocco doing the sit-up, Rocco.
What's up, Rocco?
What's up, man? How you guys doing?
No, keep working out. We're doing good. What's going on at the gym today?
Chilling, man. You know, another day in the office.
Look at this shit. Rocco working. Go, Rocco.
Working and talking. It's not easy.
Rocco.
Is this how you get a six-pack?
Hold on. We got somebody else. Got to get JT. Got to get...
Okay.
Old motherfucker right here.
JT. You know what I told him? Hey, Duane, I told him you look just like OJ.
OJ's little brother, J Tizzle. Put it in. Look at him. Look at J
what
Tizzle.
Up, what up? What up? 6 months OJ. 6 months LL Cool J.
What's up, baby? Good to see you.
Why do everyone love this gym? Everyone here is really so passionate about the gym. Like
the family affair.
Yeah, man.
It starts at the door. The family friendship.
Come on, we're gonna go to the old timer section over here.
If someone wants to train here, what does it cost a month?
I think it's like $70.
Okay.
$70 a month. This the old timer section right here.
Okay.
Old timer.
Every gym has one, you know that, right?
Yeah. And it starts with this man here. The general.
General, how you feeling today?
Work your way down. Great. Okay.
Que paso?
How you feeling?
Como te llamo?
Great.
Como te llamo? Como te llamo?
Gregorio.
Si. He works with Badu and Ronald.
Why do you love this gym?
Why?
Why do you like it? Yeah.
It's the best.
What up?
How you feeling today?
Good, I'm good.
I get Mr. Steel.
Superman?
The legend.
Hey,
Mr. Steel.
How you doing?
How you feeling today?
I'm doing great.
Jeff, what Jeff got you?
Right there.
Where black ass Jeff at? Hey Jeff. Come in, Jeff. This is Jeff Mayweather.
We're doing a tour of the gym.
The man. No. Act up, get smacked up.
You used to smack him when he was a kid?
No.
Look how big he is. Look at me.
And he trains her. She's straight from Canada. Listen.
Canada, they love fights.
We even got boxers, females. MMA. That is beautiful. Look at her.
What's your record right now?
Don't ask my record.
No, okay.
It's not very good lately.
But that's why you're here, to get better.
That's right.
All the way from Canada.
Is there anyone you want to call out right now? This is your opportunity if they're watching.
Chris is the newest member, strength and conditioning coach.
Chris, how you feeling?
How you doing?
Who do you work with here?
Everybody, all the Money Team guys.
And what's it like to work with them?
It's an honor, it's a pleasure. Guys that are driven, they work hard, they know what they want to do.
The work ethic is on another level.
Yeah, it's easy. It makes my job really easy because I just got to point them in the right direction. Sometimes I even got to slow them down because they push themselves really hard.
So we even got people that got their own private planes. Let me take you over to dance. Hey, gentlemen. Quick interview with Dan. This is Dan the Man.
First name Dan, middle name the last name Man.
That's right. So if you ever need a private plane anywhere, a private getaway, This is the man, TMT.
They made a song about him, right?
Yes, sir.
Fly like a 5'6", like a 4'6". What was the song?
I don't know.
Like a G7, straight ahead of the game.
G6.
Come out the next year, have no fear, it's already
You have a G7 already?
Got it all.
Got it all. Step it up, see? You never know what you get in the money team. All types of shit is in the gym.
But the gym does look different, though, when I look at it. I don't know why.
Yeah, it's just
new banners.
Nah, it's new banners, new floor mats. All the shit about to change, man. Once floors start working, we change all of them. So I think this is going to be green now. They changed this to green.
So how many years have you been with the camp now?
Shit. I was 21. 21, so. Ever since I came out to Vegas, actually.
What, 10 years?
I came out to Vegas. 13 years when Floyd fought his first Castillo fight.
That's a very, very long. So you've seen it all. The ups, the downs, the good, the bad, the ugly.
Yeah.
What has been Floyd's toughest fight since you joined the camp?
Toughest fight, I could say. Really, we don't really have too much tough shit as far as just like not having a whole training camp. That's the most, the hardest work is in the gym. So in the ring, it ain't shit. So most of the work, the hardest work comes in here. So he may feel like he don't want to box or something for the day or for a week. That's the toughest shit we go through. We don't really go through too much tough shit.
What has been the easiest fight, do you think?
Easiest fight out there? Probably was Guerrero because he talked so much shit.
And he made it look easy.
And he made it look so easy. Canelo was, I think probably Canelo. Canelo was the easiest fight.
Do you remember when people said that Mayweather was avoiding Canelo at some point?
Come on, man. Like even Pacquiao, like you gotta understand, people in the world got to understand it's a business at the end of the day. So if it ain't about the business, then this shit ain't gonna happen. You know, Pacquiao should go by what he should follow what Floyd and De La Hoya did. Common sense, it don't take a genius to tell him that. Once you go, you ain't gonna have no more problems. Your money gonna be there waiting for you. But you know, I'm not in his shoes. I can't judge him. I can't say nothing bad about him because we don't know what he's been through. So we just gotta keep it rocking. I wish Pacquiao nothing but the best. But I hope he comes to his senses one day.
Well, he has a fight coming up with Bradley. We'll see how he does in that. It's a very, very tough fight. Bradley's been on the road.
I think Bradley's on his on top of his head. You know, if you go to scorecards, I really think they'll give it to probably Pacquiao because of the political point aspect of it. But you know, it is what it is.
Guys in this gym, they go 21 minutes, 25 minutes,
mid,
heavy bag. It's something you don't see anywhere.
Yeah.
Who came up with that? Was that Floyd?
They watched Floyd, so they followed suit. Either you're going to rock bottom or you got to get the fuck out the gym and go to another gym.
And people, the fact that they're still here says a lot.
But the girl from Canada, did you see the girl from Canada?
I'm looking at it right now at her skills.
Damn.
She wasn't proud of her record, but you know, you got to start somewhere.
Fuck the record, dude. Did you see the girl from Canada? Did you see her?
I'm looking at it right now. How's it going?
Let's go record it, listen.
Okay.
With a psychopath.
But let me ask you this. I talk to a lot of celebrities.
Right.
And many of them tell me that they've been here.
Everybody.
Who have you met in this gym?
Man,
except from Ludacris to Justin Bieber to NBA stars like Ron Artest has been in Meta World Peace.
Man, fucking the craziest person I've met was
Joe Jackson, the father of Michael Jackson.
He always come in here.
Okay.
What's the other guy's name?
I don't know who.
The commentator dude. What's the guy's name? The dude with CNN used to do like the
Larry King.
Larry King.
Did he try boxing?
Yeah, that blew my mind to see Larry King in here.
I met him once. He's kind of dry though.
Nah, he's cool. He came here. He was cool as hell.
He has suspenders on and everything.
Yeah, cool as a fan. Larry King blew my mind.
It's funny with all the big athletes, all the football players, all the NBA guys, all the celebrities.
All come here.
They all come here. They all love boxing.
Yeah.
But yet boxing doesn't always get the same respect in mainstream media like it should get.
Right. That's just what it is, I guess.
But meeting Larry King was a highlight?
To me it was.
All right, let's go check out what Jeff is telling her. You think he can make her into a champion?
I don't know, but she's bad too.